Very first property of definite integral, and this property says that definite integrals are independent of variables. Independent of variables. Means limits must be same, and function means functions in both the integrals must be same, whether they are having x or t or y or z or w, it does not make any sense. Let's try to prove this property. So to prove it, left hand side is a to b f of x dx. This is left hand side. Now let's put x is equal to t. On putting x is equal to t, dx upon dt will be 1, which implies dx is equal to dt. That is, dx can be replaced by dt. Now let us discuss about limit. When x is a, t is x, therefore t will be a. When x is b, t will be b. Therefore, left hand side will be, therefore, left hand side will be a to b, again no change in limit, x must be replaced by t and dx by dt, which is same as RHS. Now this property can be experienced through following example. Example 1, 2, 2, x square dx is equal to x cube by 3, lower limit 1, upper limit 2. On substituting, 2 cube by 3 minus 1 cube by 3, which is, you can calculate, and the value is 7/3. Similarly, if we integrate 1, 2, 2 t square dt, again the integral will be t cube by 3, lower limit 1, upper limit 2, and the same calculation, 2 cube by 3 minus 1 cube by 3 is equal to 7/3. Therefore, you can see that both the integrals are producing same value. So it indicates that definite integrals are independent of variables.